And now we will learn how attorneys will use the QuickBooks icon bar. The icon bar is simply a set of shortcuts to the same windows that you can open from the main menu. In this video, we will learn how to delete icons, add icons, and even edit the icon bar in such a way that we can change the order of the icons or the words or the pictures that are labeled on the icon. First, we will remove the icons that QuickBooks put. So, in order to do that, it would look a lot more clear if we change the icon bar to the traditional view. That means the icon should be across the top of the screen rather than here in the left panel. From the main menu, click View, Top Icon Bar, and you can see these are the same icons to the same shortcuts to the same windows, except if your QuickBooks window is a little bit squashed and not quite open all the way, you might get this double arrow telling you that if you click, you can get to the remaining icons that aren't shown because the window is restored to a medium state. In order to delete the icons, you click from the main menu, View, Customize Icon Bar. Now, notice in the Customize Icon Bar window, this panel here allows you to scroll up, and you can see on the top that the individual labels in the panel correspond to the individual icons on the icon bar. If you click on one of them, for example, the second one down, Client Review, that's the second one from the left, and then you click Delete, it will disappear, and the other icons will move to the left and collapse the empty space. Delete. Notice the statement writer moved to the left, and it moved up in the panel because we deleted it. If we click on the statement writer and we click delete, all the other ones move to the left and so on. I can click the top one and click delete many times to delete all of the icons that QuickBooks put so that we can put only the icons that we need for our law firm. And that will save us a tremendous amount of time in the remainder of the course. Be careful. If you click cancel, the changes won't save and they'll come back. See? So again, View, Customize Icon Bar, keep clicking Delete until they're all gone, and then when they're gone, make sure you click OK. Now, we will put up the transaction windows that we usually use in our law firm. That's the reason the icon bar saves us time. The window we will use most is the Receive Payment window. From the main menu, click Customer Receive Payment. This is the window that you'll open up when you receive retainer payments or even payments in advance for any kind of service in your law firm. Once the window is active and in front of you, you can then click from the main menu, View, Add Receive Payments to the icon bar, and then click OK. Notice the shortcut has been put up. When we close the window, we can click on the shortcut and the window opens up. The other window that attorneys use all the time is the Create Invoice window. From the main menu, click Customers, Create Invoice. Once the Create Invoice window is the active window and open in front of you, you can go to the top left of the main menu and click View, Add Create Invoice to the icon bar, and then click OK. Notice the shortcut is here, and you can test it out by closing the invoice window, clicking on the shortcut, and it opens right up. And now we will put customized reports in the icon bar. These are reports that law firms need and help us find things in QuickBooks that we're looking for. Now, in the future, there will be a video discussing the customization and explaining exactly how to customize any QuickBooks report for any of the things that you need. But for now, just follow the steps just to be able to get the reports looking the way we need it to look at the beginning of the course. And we'll circle back later if you want to change some of the details. So, from the main menu, click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Trial Balance. Now, your trial balance is your main report. It shows the results of every account in your chart of accounts, which we will learn about soon. Push A for All on your keyboard to make sure that the pull-down menu option shows all. This means we want the trial balance to show us the results of all transactions, regardless of date. Once the trial balance looks the way we want it to look, we will save it in the icon bar, and the beautiful thing about the icon bar is that it will save the customization. So, from the top left, we click View, and we click Add Trial Balance to the icon bar, and then we click OK. If we close the trial balance, by the way, you should click the Don't Bother Me box, and it won't keep asking you if you want to memorize reports every time you try to close them. We don't need to use the Memorize Report feature because the icon bar will save the reports already customized. So using the icon bar is like memorizing the reports anyway. So we're just going to say, don't bother me, click the checkbox here, click No. Now watch. If we go back to the main menu and click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Trial Balance, it opens up with the default date, last month, whatever the last month is. But we changed this before we saved it into the icon bar. So if we click to open the trial balance from the icon bar, we then see that when we open it from the icon bar, it remembered that we wanted to show the results of all transactions. Here, I'll close this one. All transactions, regardless of date. So open your report, change it to the way you need it to look, and then put it up in the icon bar. And it won't look the way it looked first when it came from the main menu, like this one. It'll look the way it opened from the icon bar, like that one. The next report is one of the most important reports to work with in QuickBooks. It's called the Journal. From the main menu, click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Journal. Now, you'll get a message telling you about all the lovely features, but I like to click the Don't Bother Me box so it won't pop up again, and click OK. And again with the journal, just like with the trial balance, we're going to make sure that the date selection is all, meaning we want to see the results of all transactions, regardless of date. Now the journal is going to be one of the most important reports in your entire QuickBooks usage because it is the only report that not only shows every transaction that's ever been entered into this file since it has been created, but it also is the only report that by default shows things in the order in which they were entered into the computer, regardless of date. That will happen if you choose the pull down all. It shows order entered. Now, we still have to adjust it to remove some of the irrelevant columns and add some very important columns. So I'm going to make it a little bit wider before I save it. So if you want to further modify a report, any report in QuickBooks, you go to the top left and you click Customize Reports. Notice there are four tabs, and we click the Display tab. If you click the Display tab, the bottom left panel has a label for every possible column your report can show. The first one we will add is this one. Click the check mark here, entered last modified by. We click the check mark, click OK, and it will add that column. This column is so important because this column is the date of the transaction, but this column is the date and time that that transaction was either entered or most recently changed. All the other irrelevant columns we can simply remove or edit. So again, in the top left, click Customize Reports. Again, we're in the Display tab, and let's just remove some of the ones we don't need. We can click the check mark here. We don't need the adjustment column. Click the scroll down. We should keep memo, should keep account. But I would say click to remove the debit and credit check marks and click on amount, because I think we only really need one column to know the money amount, and click OK. And now that the journal looks the way we need it to look, from the top left of the main menu, click View, click Add Journal to the icon bar, and click OK. Now, when we click here, it looks the way it looks when we saved it, and it looks the way we need it to look for our little QuickBooks adventure. Now, anytime you want to edit the icon bar in any way, obviously you would click View, Customize Icon Bar, and it's very simple. You can change the order of the icons by moving the mouse to the left and click on the little dot and drag that particular icon to a different position. For example, I would like to move the journal between the payment and the invoice. So I go to the left dot and click, and I drag till I see the line. Then I lift my finger up and notice it's moved. But remember, if you don't click OK, it'll jump back. So that's how you change the position. Let's change it back. View, Customize Icon Bar. Click here in the dot and drag it down. Notice it changed again. You also can add a separator, because these two here, the first two are transactions. The next two are reports. So what you could do is you could click right below where you want the separator to be and click Add Separator. Actually, that was wrong. Click on the separator and click Delete. You should click above where you want the separator to be and click Add Separator, maybe twice, then click OK, and now you've added a separator. You can also change the label and the picture in the icon bar. View, Customize. If I click on Payment and I want to edit the word, I want it to say Payment-Retainer. You can change that. And you can change the mouse tip when you hover the mouse over it. And you can choose a different icon if you want to, but we will not. Let's just click OK. And now it says Payment Retainer in the right place. Click OK for the customized window. And that's how you utilize the icon bar to your advantage.